Mary Ann, she asked me a couple weeks ago if I'd just give a couple of remarks. As I've been pondering on what to talk about, I've been thinking a lot about freedom and what freedom really means and what I would give for freedom. And when I joined, I raised my right hand and swore to defend and protect the Constitution with my life if necessary. And as I've separated from the military and still pondered on that, I haven't revoked on that oath. And so I have decided that now the life I've been blessed to live after my military service, I need to revoke to freedom. One challenge I do have for everybody in the room, if it's been more than a week or two since you've read the Constitution, go ahead and read it. It's really not that long. It takes about 5, maybe 10 minutes to read through the Constitution. That truly is the banner of freedom that goes around the world today, is that Constitution. Our flag is a big visual representation of the Constitution, but that's true freedom, and it's what gives us the freedom. On my second deployment, it was right in the middle of it. It was the summer of 2010. It was just felt like a long, hot, miserable time. We were tasked. We flew into Iraq. And then we were picking some stuff up and taking it into Afghanistan this particular day. And as we landed in Iraq, it was about an hour before sunset, and it was too hot for us to take off until after the sun went down. And they'll never want to see 140 degrees on the thermometer again. It can get too hot for airplanes to fly. And so finally, it cooled off enough. We were able to take off, and as we reached cruise, and the air conditioning in the jets finally starting to work a little bit, I look at the calendar and I realize this is the 4th of July today. And so I got thinking about, well, what's going on at home for the 4th of July? And in mind's eye, I could see families getting together and barbecues going on, fireworks, and all of that, and I just had the thought, that's what freedom is. It's being able to spend time with your family and to enjoy life, have good food. That's what it's really about. So for this Veterans Day and every Veterans Day and the time in between, just think about what freedom really means.